That John Rutsey Mania, one wild on you. This is great. Hello there, everybody. This is Getty 92 coming at you today with a new episode of your Daily Dose of Wash. And today we're gonna take a look on a song which was actually scheduled to be on the, I think, 1974 Wash album. It ended up on a B-side. I think it was scratched out. So therefore, this song, You Can't Fight It. You may have not heard this one before. You may have never heard this one before. And I'm 100% sure I've never heard this one. So let's get right into You Can't Fight It. And there is no lyrics video of it. So I will be the big guy on the screen then. And we will listen to You Can't Fight It by Wash. And I promise to you, you might have never heard this one before. All right, here we go. Moon Records, side number two. You Can Find It. Let's listen to this one. I love this already. And I'm amazed by this song already. Wow, listen to the drums, they are amazing. This really was amazing, and whoever says that John Rutsey couldn't play any kind of good drums there, you were wrong. You were dead wrong, brother. Let John Rutsey Mania one wild on you. This is great. I haven't expected this. I actually expected kind of like standard kind of like rock song, but I didn't expect it such a great drumming there. I didn't expect this at all, but especially if you listen closely to the Wash first album, to the 1974, you can clearly hear the difference between John and Neil, but this one here, this should have been on the first record. This is a great, great song. And I think this would be an amazing song and as legendary as probably it would have become Working Man. I think this is really fair to say that this is a great song. And I'm just amazed. I mean, the sound quality wasn't that great, wasn't that good at all. But in general, love the drums. I really appreciate the guitar there. Down, 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 down. And all along, the bass is playing the same stuff. And Geddy's vocals, sometimes they were like double vocals or triple vocals going on there. Amazing. I really love this song. I don't think that this song is kind of like on Spotify or somewhere else. I need to check on this one. But wow, this is a great song. And let me know, have you heard this song before? Or haven't you heard this song before? That would be really interesting to know. So therefore, guys, this is a shorter episode because that song only is 2 minutes and 51 seconds long. And tomorrow we will do a song called Making Memories. And I actually was very wrong when I said yesterday that You Can Find It, Fight It was a strong lyrical thing there and was a meaningful song. I don't think that this song is meaningful at all because it's a rock song, standard rock song. But in general, I love this song. I really do. What do you think about this song? And I mean, if you happen to be a fan from the like late 70s era or 80s era, or if you are deep into the synthesizing era of Rush, I think this song will not be something for you. But on the same bill, you can then say, well, the first record isn't something for you. So let me know what you think about this song, guys. And see you tomorrow with a new song from a very good album, I guess. We will listen to Dating Memories. Thanks, guys. Bye.